Well, about to show you my star carrier. I'm working on this thing for a few months. It's based off of books by Craig Allenson, referred to as Expeditionary Force. So you might actually see quite a resemblance. This thing is just shy of a kilometer long, weighs 166 megatons. It has 42 jump drives. Yeah, the answer was 42. Didn't jump with 24. Went nowhere. Did the glorious light show and didn't go anywhere. Let's check out the bridge. This is a temporary construction platform. Fresh air. Now the airlock still didn't hold in the air like they were supposed to. Jump coil status matrix. All these little bars are the jump coil charges. Depending on the jump, these bars will knock out and recharge slowly. This is the power usage grid. Looks like radar is taking up more power at a megawatt. Everything's running in super low power state. Nothing's really running. No refineries are really doing anything. This is components overlay. All these batteries in here that are glowing yellow are part of a backup battery grid. This is the CIC. Upper command. Still working on lighting. Some areas are unlit. I haven't been able to figure out if it's 1.2 million liters of air or 400,000 in total across this ship. We're in engineering now. These reactors are ejectable. These gravity generators will essentially aid in ejecting the reactors for, you know, scenic fun, you know, if you wanted to actually eject a reactor core out of the engineering bay. Why not, right? For fucks. Alright. Engineering bay's kind of a mess. Kind of, I mean, for what's going on. I figure this is kind of fun, you know, rotating reactors. Well, you know, you got high power Titan engines back here, half enclosed in atmosphere. Which is weird. See this down here? I never been able to figure this out. Okay, so here there's atmosphere, see? Atmosphere, and it's warm down in the bottom there. But you go just a little further over, and then, right. Oh, well. Okay, maybe it's just up here. That's weird. See right there. I think it's vacuum over here. I don't know why. It's really strange. Wonder how that would affect the character. I wouldn't know. I have it on God mode right now just so I can get things done, not keep dying. Well, here's the back door. Jetpack accessible because I don't want people coming in. You know. It's really secured, but you know, whatever. Ah, come on. Alright. Yeah. Titan engines. Jump coils. pretty cool because they go yellow when you jump. You know, something happened. Something impacted over here. It's interesting. I have asteroids and Armageddon so I can watch the lasers shoot. I'm sure while we're out here it'll happen. It's okay. I'll be fine. I have unlimited fuel. 24 frames. Look at all these gyroscopes I had to add. I had to bring it from 700 to 1078 gyroscopes just to get the thing to turn in any noticeable amount. More gyroscopes in the spine. Each platform in her base. I'm gonna take all the heavy armor, well not all of it, huge square of it out of these platforms. And replace it with light armor. I might be able to get it down a few megatons. Oh yeah, I'm even showing you this shiz. Oh, good, it's already open. Isn't that glorious? Alright. This is the main hangar bay. It's not as big as it needs to be according to the book, but jeez. The scale in that book just... Those books is just quite something else. Alright, so we need to close the doors. We'll check out the nanite core. Alright, turn on Atmos. Ta-da. I should have probably turned on my airlock code. Why not, right? Let's do that real quick. There we go. And looks like we're green. Alright. So here's the nanite core with all its upgrades. Reactor banks. Which is crazy. All reactors around this corridor. See? This is a nose. The upper platforms, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Put on the auto doors to help preserve oxygen. It says in the book that you have to go into vacuum in order to get to the inner ship from a platform. Only certain platforms have access to ships, to ship interiors. Might just make a little staircase down to come down. I don't know. Why not, right? This barely scratches the surface. This thing is just enormous. These are the two ships that I've successfully jumped with. This thing will jump about 180 megatons with these two ships is what it comes out to be. It'll go just shy of 600 kilometers, which to the scale of this universe is quite fitting if you look at the distances to Venus and Mercury from a bit of a ways away from Earth here. Place so I can still get to it if I go far. This is a Thuranin. Well, I depict as a Thuranin battlecruiser, but it's not really all made by me. There's a blueprint I found that I vamped up. Same with this thing, really. But considering the changes I made to it from the original blueprint, it might as well be mine. Because it really is vastly different. I really only kept the chassis, if you want to call it that. It's a fun little bugger. It's a little bigger than a frigate, so I went with destroyer. There's an E, the next class up is destroyer, and well, from what I've heard, it seems pretty destroyer fit. Two railguns. It's interesting though, the battlecruiser's only got two railguns, so might have to change. I'm gonna have to put the upgraded reactors in it too, just to make up. This thing's fun though. Let's do a little maneuver. Atmosphere, can get out of atmosphere. It's very, very versatile for a destroyer. Land this thing on a planet, make it your main base, no problemo. Land on top of a good mountain, and oh man, cover this baby will provide. The mining vessel attached to its flank here is capable of probably large moon level gravity. I haven't tested it. Atmos, so it probably would need some atmospheric thrusters that can tilt. Yeah, that would be fair. Man, I wish those two big platforms that are close to the smaller ones were further over. Man, it does really kind of take away from it. I needed a dock. So it is what it is. Get skinny. Inertial dampers on, so it's fighting my main ship here.